Crafty Peeps is Angel Holt with Angel Holt Designs. Okay, I worked for 2 days to do this Prima chandelier. And as you can see, I've done some beautiful inlaid work on the chandelier, some deco foil, pearls, and all this. Well, it broke into several pieces. I was devastated. I mean, I had little dangles on here, which I'll use later. But I was devastated. I was like, oh, it broke. And it broke at the weakest points when I was trying to put it together. As you see, here's a broken piece here. But I thought to myself, I'm like, you know what? I am going to make something out of this. I mean, I even kept the broken pieces here that broke off and stuff. And I said, I'm going to do something with this. And I have a Prima, one of the beautiful Prima resin frames, and I am going to create a very maybe avant-garde or different or very, very mixed media thing out of this because I don't want to waste it because I put 2 days' work in it. And so if you like this video, if you would like for me to show you how I created this look here, let me know by giving me a like on my video and letting me know in the comment section below if you would like to learn this technique here on how to get it, see how it looks like it's inlaid and gilded-y looking and stuff. So I am going to turn this broken piece into a beautiful piece. I used a vintage photo that I have, and I measured it perfectly. The dimensions of the photo is perfectly measures this frame here, as you see. And then I'm going to glue this onto here, like somehow like this. I'm gonna put some flowers and some decoration and everything. And I think I'm gonna call this piece, I don't, a fragile maybe, or broken but strong. You know what I'm saying? Broken but beautiful. What I want to do to kind of come out of this saying that even though this is broken, it's still beautiful. So that's along the lines of what I want to do with this piece. So to get started, I'm gonna work on the frame. Now I put 2 layers of gesso on here, and this is the heavy gesso, Art Basics heavy gesso by Finovar, which is by Prima. You get a large tub of this, and this is awesome. Excuse me. Also, I am pulling out the acrylic paint here from Prima. This is one of their metallic light patinas. So I'm going to get my paintbrush and I'm going to paint this the frame in the patina. And I'm going to show you a couple ways I'm going to age this frame because I really want it to pop. I would have started on this earlier today, but we had gotten some bad storms. So I'm just taking up the brush and I'm pouncing it into all the grooves like this. And you want to get it in all of the grooves. Just like that. By pouncing it, you're getting it, you know, in those small little Inkatrip areas that are hard to get into. Once I get the front dried, I will do the sides as much as I can because I don't want to There we go. Very beautiful color. Love this color. Okay. Let me get my heat gun. Okay, now I'm gonna do the sides. I've got my mojo back, ladies. Mojo back. I know my haters don't like that. Oh, yeah. The new thing going on now, I have spirits in my videos that talk to me. Yeah. Spirits that are talking to my fans and stuff. That's the new thing now from the bullies. That I have a spirit that they can hear on my video, and it says, "You're lying, you're lying." So, if y'all hear any spirits in my videos, just let me know, because I was very unaware that I have spirits in my videos. You know? Yeah, and the person that said I had spirits in my videos is the one with the seven personalities. Maybe one of her person, maybe she heard herself say she's lying. Because I tried my damnedest to hear it. All right. Now, I'm going to take this Lindy's Stamp Gang Spray Bodacious Blush. And this is my favorite color. And it's so pretty. It's like a pink brown. And I'm really going to get in there in the crevices. I want it to soak in like this. And you're going to heat gun this. Okay. Loving the look so far. Stunning. Now, I'm going to put a little bit of Gilder's deco foil on here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of the adhesive and just going to rub it on certain areas. I don't want it everywhere. I just want it tacky in certain areas. If you've never worked with deco foil, this is the adhesive. It's deco foil adhesive, and it will dry tacky. And that's what I want. And so that it can attach the deco foil. And the deco foil color that I'm using is gold. So, and I had a sheet of it because that's what I used on here, was the deco foil on the candles. And but I'm after this thing broke, I was determined, I was upset. I worked on that for 2 days, 2 days, because I would be chatting with May on Skype and just sitting here gluing and stuff, and yeah, it got damaged. So here's the foil from Deco Foil. I think Prima has their own foil that I would love to try. Might be something in there. I'm looking into starting to bring in more Prima products because I want to start working with their products more. Because everything they're bringing out, man, just flipping rocks. Oh my God. It rocks. So I'm gonna dry this to a tacky. Okay, and it's tacky, so what I'm going to do is just lay it on here like this. And I'm just gonna rub, and you see where if I rub across it, it's only picking up where it's tacky. See? See right there? It's only picking up where it's tacky. See, it won't pick up right there because I didn't put nothing tacky on it. But right here it would. So now you're just gonna lift. Look at that. Just go over it and lift. And lift. I just love this stuff. Nope, no more techie. There we go. Only touched in those areas, and that's exactly where I wanted it to be. Beautiful. Stunning. And yes, keep this because you can use it over and over until you absolutely use all the gold off of it. So you can, you can. Now, I am going to touch this with the High Point with this product. Absolutely love. I sold out of it in my store. If you want me to order some more, let me know in the comment section below. But this is called Nuvo Embellishment Mousse. It is by Tonic Studios, and this color is Mother of Pearl. Now, that's exactly what I used on this piece to give it that sheen look right there. So I'm going to use a little bit of it on the frame. And all you're going to do is get some on your finger, and you're just going to rub it on the high points. Oh my god, this is my most favorite color. Oh, it's gorgeous. I'm gonna have to order some more of this to get it in the stores. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. And see, I'm only rubbing it on the high points. And you can even go over some of the gold to kind of dull it a little bit to make it look even more antiqued and aged. You can see there like that. I am just doing that, and I'm gonna do some on the sides here like that. Like that. Oh wow, yeah. Between all of these techniques, look at the luster and the vintage look, the darkness of the Lindy stamp game seeping into the creases, and then the gold on top of the mousse. Beautiful frame. So now, when you lay the frame down, it's got some character. So, now what I'm going to do is simply glue this to here, and I'm using hot glue to do it. Okay. Make sure. There we go. She's in there. Isn't that gorgeous? Gorgeous. Okay, now this is the broken piece that I'm gonna be working with. So sad. I've done all that work. So sad. But we're refurbishing it in a different way. Now, I am going to, I pulled out some old music note paper. I was thinking about taking it and kind of rolling it into a scroll like deal like this, and then putting it somewhere. I'm definitely going to pull out a bunch of flowers. I've got some pulled out over here. I'm going to get some other embellishments, and then we're going to put this puppy together. Okay, so let me gather up some other embellishments, and I will be right back. Okay, so first things first, is I'm going to put some, I've pulled out a bunch of stuff that I just want to play with. I am going to add something to the back of the frame to give it, I don't know, some more, you want to say? So I'm going to add a piece of cheesecloth. Just to give it that grungier feel to it. Cheesecloth can be purchased at your local department store, craft store. If you purchase it in a grocery store, it might be back there with the spices or something, because or it could be around the meats. Depends on where you go, because it's made to be cooked with, and makes a little herb sachets for stews and brews and all that stuff. So you can order it online as well. So I'm just going to tack this down with a little bit of hot glue, because I am going to be putting another layer of stuff on top of here. Just gonna put just a little bit. Just kind of lay it down like that. Just so it just kind of stays in place. Now, I also pulled out some trims and stuff, and I pulled out some more Prima stuff that I had, like the little bird and some birds and stuff. Also, I pulled out some of the paper airplay pieces I made using Prima's molds. I pulled out some flowers. I just have a slew of stuff here on my counter. So now I'm going to flip it over. Yeah. So now what I want to do is kind of add some lace behind it. I'm just going to press it like that. And then I'm going to trim it like this. Lay that down. Do the same thing up here. I'm gonna lay this down and just, yeah, I'm gonna do it like that. Flip it over. Make sure I get all of the little ends down. Like that. Again, I'm going to trim. I'm going along the pattern of the lace. This lace can be bought at May's store. Very beautiful lace. So now, I don't know. Yeah, I'm going to go this way with it. Let's see. Pull this back a little bit. Let's see. Line that up. Yeah. Okay. So I'm just going to lift. Add a bead of hot glue. Like that. I'm gonna line these curves up. Line that curve up. There we go. Very stunning. Stunning, stunning. And then I'm gonna snip it off right there. Then I'm going to snip this one off. Again, playing with the pattern. Kind of like that. I don't want it perfect because I'm not after perfection. Ooh, my table is dirty. Where I've done all of that work and it broke. I should have cleaned my table off. But I wasn't expecting for it to break. So, alright. Now I'm going to do this side. And pull out the cheesecloth a little bit more. Like that. Make sure I have this little area glued down. Pull out the cheesecloth like that, which makes it beautiful looking. And now I'm going to just add some glue. I wonder something. No, I'll go ahead and just lay it over it. Okay, so I'm gonna add some glue and kind of stick with the beautiful. Now, what I'm going to do is get a piece of chipboard. And I'm going to cut roughly about what its size it is. Straighten it up. Make sure you always want to back things like this so it looks good. So I'm just going to run a bead of hot glue down the edges. Maybe one like that. Like so. I'll just press it down. Like so. Isn't that gorgeous? Just look so pretty. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Oh, yeah. Now, we're going to go back to our piece that broke. Now, one thing I found was is that when I hang it, it's going to hang at a, it's going to hang dang to the one to one side because one side is heavier than the other. So I have to compensate for that. And I'm hanging it up. And as you can see, this piece is going this way, but the frame is being, and that's because that's the way it hangs, because this piece is heavy. So I am going to compensate for that and I'm going to start by running a bead of glue down the center. Press firmly. Now I'm gonna take it and oh yeah, that's gorgeous. Gorgeous! Okay, now I'm gonna look in the back. As you see here, I am going to add glue. This area like that. Then I'm going to add some along there. a little bit right in there. So that should be plenty to keep that held on. Okay, so now that we got the frame finished and everything, I found this Prima Vine, but I'm going to change the flowers out of it because I don't like these flowers. So that's the fun part that we get to play. I might keep, I don't know. Let's see. No, it's too much blue. So I'm just going to remove the flower. I would keep the flowers for something else, but I want the vine. So I'm just removing the flower itself from the vine. And I'll replace it with another beautiful flower. Nothing you get is permanent. You can always change it to what you want. So here's the vine. I love Prima's vines. They are such a beautiful investment. I have loved them from day one. And I just love them. Because they add so much character to your pieces. And it's just gorgeous. It's just gorgeous. So, very beautiful. So here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lift some of this lace up. Have it lay kind of like that so that it looks like the vine is growing through it. And as I go, I am going to be gluing this down. It doesn't take much glue, but let me see if I can zoom in for y'all, because I know this is a lot of detail work. Yeah, there we go. All right. Okay. Now here is where a flower is. And see where this is loose? I'm going to have to glue it down, glue the lace down to a sturdier piece so that this doesn't move a lot, as you will see. Like right there. Are you able to see? Now you see all the details in the frame. Okay, then we're going to, I wonder where that one fell off. We'll have to find it a new home. Then here, I'm probably going to glue it onto the frame or just bend it to go onto the frame. I don't know yet. Depends on the flower I use. I think I'm going to tack it like right here in one little area, just so that it will stay in that one little area. There we go. Then I'm gonna start adding my flowers, but I'm holding this down. Okay. Now I'm gonna move my camera a little bit so you can see. Okay, now you're gonna do some focal flowers. Now, I'm gonna use some of these. These are some wild orchid craft flowers because I'm completely out of my primas. It's so sad. Flowers are flowers, though. Okay, so I'm gonna glue these pink roses to the same spots that were cut off. Like, here we go. Just glue that one. You gotta hold it because you gotta let that glue dry just a moment. I just love this. I love how it's coming out. Okay, the next rose will go right there. And we're going to put it down just like that. And I am gluing it to the frame. As you can see right there, I am gluing it to the frame. Okay, so now we have one here. And I'm going to glue it right there. Very beautiful. Lovely. Okay. Like I said, I pulled out a bunch of stuff. I pulled out some Diamante chain. I pulled out this beautiful pearl cluster, thinking maybe it would look good on there, but I think that's going to be too much. I also pulled out some of May's beautiful appliques, and they're just gorgeous, gorgeous appliques. I think I know what I'm gonna do. Okay, so I'm gonna take this applique. Oh, let me raise my. Okay, I'm gonna take this applique. These are found at May's store at creatingwithdetailstore.com. Okay, look at that. Isn't that pretty? I think I'm gonna put it right up there like that to kind of hide that imperfection. Let me show you right there to hide this imperfection. So that's all what I'm gonna do. Yep. And then this can hang down like that, maybe. And then I'm going to get some larger flowers. Where's my large pink flowers? The large ones I had. I saw these little boogers. Don't you hate that? You set them out and then they disappear. They say, I don't want to play today. Okay, set that up there. Set that up there. Oh, here they are. There's one. Oop, here's some more bling. Bling, bling, bling. Okay. I'll have to deal with those for right now. Okay, sorry about that. All right, here is one large focal flower. And want to lift this up. Maybe push. I'll go ahead and glue that down so that it can remain. It will stay glued down that way. Okay, now we can do a large focal flower like that. I have some beautiful larger leaves. These are all from Wild Orchid Crafts. I have some darker color flowers. Don't know if I want to use them. Oh, I do have some buds I might throw in there. I might throw a few of those in there. Let's see. That's six right there, so that'll be an even count. So I'm just gonna take these. You see, I'm gonna take these and then tie them together like that. Snip off. Erase the camera a little bit so you see what I'm doing. You know, kind of put them in there like that. Right now, I'm playing around. I'm doing my placement first to see if I like what I'm doing here. Again, just going to take these and twist. There we go. So we have that. We can put that in there like that. Let's see what. Now this can be, I think I'm just going to snip this off of the. So this is going to be my large focal flower. So I'm going to glue it down like that. Then I'm going to glue first of the spray, the little rose buds like that. Okay, then I'm gonna put a leaf. I'm gonna put another leaf. Think I'm gonna put it right in there, like that. And then put this other set of buds coming out like that. All right. Then I might add a few more of these pink ones. Just to tie it in. Might put one right in there. There we go. Okay. So yeah, I have all these little broken pieces with beads on them. You know, I can probably put broken piece. Oh yeah, I'm gonna put it right there. I'm gonna do a little bit of that. I'm gonna find another piece. Then I'm gonna put one. I think I'm gonna put a piece of it right there. Okay. There we go. In there like that. It's hot up in here. Okay, so kind of pull these out a little bit. You can move them around to work in your favor like that. Okay, now let me raise this up and see what it looks like. Oh, it's so gorgeous. It's very, very shabby chic. It is definitely making something broken and old, new and beautiful. Definitely. You know. Ooh, I might put that there. Because that made looking pretty. Oh yeah, put that there, and here's another piece I can put right there. Just like that, I put it right here. Let me back out a little bit. There we go. Don't know. I think it's turning out beautiful. Now you can add a touch of feather, but I don't know if I want to. You know, it could be a little too much. But I think I want to add this piece of broken, it's not broken, it's just cut away. You know, add it. Like that, just to give some more bling. So when you hang it up, you can see lots of bling. Okay. See, I'm gonna put it just love that. I just love it. I love, love, love it. Let's see, what can I do here? Now, I did, like I said, I pulled out some Prima stuff. I pulled out these. But I don't want to. I just don't want to cover up any of my. Now I might can do that. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, yes. Yes, mommy, come to me. Ooh, yep, I'm gonna put it right there on the candle part. And I'm gonna paint it up and do like I did here. So let's set this aside. And what we're gonna do, this is already has a gesso feeling to it, so I'm just gonna take my paintbrush here, and we're just going to repeat what we've done to the frame. So I'm just going to really get in there. Like so. All right. Make sure I put a lid on that stuff. Whew. All right. Oh, gonna hit it with a heat gun. Like that. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is do the deco foil. And just brush it in areas that I want gold. Then we're going to heat gun it. Now we're going to get the foil. Where did I lay the foil at? It's a $50 question. Where did I lay the foil? I had it earlier. Oh, I've got too much on my desk. Way too much. Oh, here it is. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is just lay this on here. Let's Isn't that gorgeous? Look. Gorgeous. And then, of course, a little bit of the mousse. We have put a little bit of the mousse. Mousse, 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 mousse. Okay. All done. Now we're going to take this piece here. And we're going to come back to our main piece. Put that in its water. Come back to the main piece here. And we are going to glue this right there, my friend. Just like that. There you go. Look at it there. Isn't that beautiful? Yep, it's laying flat. Now, what do I want to do? No, I don't want to do that. I don't want to put none of that on there. That's a piece I made using the Prima molds. But let me think on it. I'm going to clean up my mess here and then I'll be right back as to if I want to do anything to this area here. I'm going to hang it up and kind of look at it and see if there's anything I need to add. And if there is, I'll come back and show you most definitely. So I will be back in just a moment. Okay, now to fix this area here, I found took another broken piece and it fits perfectly like that. So I'm going to glue it. Down. See, because it fits perfectly just like so. Just like that. Okay? Let me clip off the little ridges here. So I'm trying to utilize as much of this broken chandelier as I can. I'm going to hold it in place. Like that. And what I did was, is I took the other two pieces and done the same way as I did this piece here. And I'm going to lay them just like that. And we're going to call this piece finished. Bam. And bam. Like that. Yep, I think it's done. I think it turned out beautiful. What I might do here, I don't know, is maybe add a really pretty piece of ribbon I have some ribbon laid out. Yeah, I have this brown ribbon. I might paint. Let's see. Yeah, I have enough. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna paint this. Thought it was almost done. Okay, let's dry that real quick. All right, let's spray it with some of the Lindy's that I'm almost out of. Okay, then we're going to do a little bit of the deco. Yeah. Oop, too much. Oh, I hate my lazy kids. Really? Oh, there's my white flowers I was looking for. Okay, that should dry. We'll get this to dry. And yes, this piece will be in my store along with my two, or along with other projects that I've made. Will be in my store for sale for somebody to purchase and enjoy, because the more I make, the more less room I have. So, and I want everybody to enjoy my pieces and own a piece. I'm gonna paint this up just a little bit more. There we go. Now I'm just gonna lay this on here like that. Bam. See? Isn't that beautiful? And then put some mousse on it. Edges here, like that, and there you have it, ladies. Made a broken disaster look stunningly gorgeous, I think. And I will work on this dangle, because this dangle's getting on my nerve now. There it goes. Yeah, there it goes. Now it all dangles like that. So here's the piece. Stay for photos and for detailed photos. So if you have any questions about any of the products I've used, let me know in the comment section below. If you like this project and would like for me to teach you again how to do this look on things, give me a thumbs up. Also, like, share, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. I would appreciate if you share my videos with everyone for everyone to watch. Tell all your crafty friends and everything to learn how to do shabby chic mixed media. Just a little bit of everything on my channel. And but I'm absolutely love this piece. And yes, it will be in my store for sale in my Etsy shop. And there will be a link in the description box down below. So until next crafty project, ladies, I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.